Hi, I'm Paweł Spechalski, and in theory I should not really be hyped about the new propellers, because there are plenty propellers on the market that everybody can find something for himself. However, in this case I am kinda hyped, because it's hard to find a propeller that is designed for 7-incher quad, that has 7 inch of the diameter. It's a B-blade, it's efficient, and it's something else than the Gemfan Flash 7042. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that the Gemfan Flash is a bad propeller, but it's far from perfect because of some of the flimsiness of the design, and it's really easy to go with the Gemfan Flash into the grizzle mode when it's just making amazing sound in the air, but it's not really very efficient. This is why I was very interested when I got a sample from the Foxeer, which is a Dalprop New Cyclone. Yes, because the Cyclone brand is back. The New Cyclone 7040, so 7 inches pitch, 4 inches, B-blade propellers. Why B-blade, not 3-blade? Because at the tip of the blade, the vortex is forming, that is sucking energy from the propeller, and as the result, the propeller with more blades is less efficient than the propeller with less blades. So if you want to go far, or if you want to fly longer, the propeller with less blades is kind of better than the propeller with more blades. So what are we gonna do today? I already have installed the new Cyclone 7040 on my Pirc 7, which is a long ranger, and we're gonna fly here around, see does it maybe require any different tune than the other propellers, because currently this thing is flying on Dalprop's Faults F7 and the HQ Prop 7x4x3 with the same pits, no changes required. And I will just let you know what I think about this thing after flying, like, I don't know, few packs, maybe even slightly more than the few packs. So let me get my chair, let me put my goggles, and let me have some fun. And now it's time to answer the question, how was it? And before I will say anything about the new Cyclone's B-blade 7040 for the endurance, long range, and cruiser 7-inch quads. A, today's weather is not really a good weather to tell much about the stability and the smoothness and the performance in the best flying conditions, because I was making tests today when usually at more or less the same inclination angle I'm flying 40-50 kilometers per hour. Today at 100 meters up I was flying forward only at 5 kilometers per hour. So I would say that today at 100 meters we have at least 40 kilometers winds, and here on the ground level not only the air is super jumpy, there is a lot of holes, it's super windy, and it's a lot of gusts. I also have a rotor on the line of the trees, so stability was not something that I was able really to check on those propellers. However, from the beginning, from the start, you feel that this is not the propeller made for speed. Because even the hover point is much higher. I would have to say maybe even 20% higher than usual. My hat just wanted to flew away. Higher than usual. So this is not a super flippity floppy, super high thrust propeller. Sounds good. I was not able to force the propeller to go into any audible oscillations, like for example the Gemfan Flash are going into. Even at the high throttle, it was behaving fine, there was no flutter, so it is a good sign. Hard to determine much about the efficiency. I think that this is indeed a better efficiency than, for example, Fold F7 V2s I was using before, and definitely comparable with the Flash, but this is like after flying for an hour with this propeller, it's still too early to say. However, I do not see any red flags yet. So far so good, and it might be the next best things for the 7-inch flyers if they want to go far. But exactly like I expected, if you use this propeller, you will have to retune your quad. After the first takeoff on the exactly the same tune I'm using on the HQ Prop 7x4x5x3 V1S and on the Fold 7 F7 V2, the whole quad felt drunk. Really, like it was going places, unable to keep a straight line, and you see that this thing is just delivering much less thrust. And the same tune you had for the two-bladed propellers is definitely not what you want to use. I fixed that. I fixed that by raising the peak gains by 50%. Yes, the peak gains I raised by 50% and the D gains by around 30%. And then in flight it was stable again. However, like I mentioned before, it's super windy today and it's super hard to say how much of the instability I had was really caused by still unperfect tune or something else or just the wind that is like everywhere. But I will be using this propeller more because I want to make myself familiar with this thing more, because I see a lot of potential for this prop. Because this is the only viable competition I am aware of the B-bladed Gemfan Flash. There's nothing else I'm really 100% aware of that is not three-bladed. And even on the three-bladed market for 7-inch propellers, there is not really that much of the options to choose from. So yeah, I'm hyped. Maybe less than before because there are like so those problems, but this propeller stay on my Pirc 7 for quite longer, and it's not folding. Dalprop Foxeer, make a B-bladed folding cyclone. Haha, that might be interesting. Very little place taken by the propeller. That's something definitely. So I think that's all for today. Early summary. Bad day for testing. Thoroughly. I will be looking more at this propeller. So far I'm happy with what it does, but requires retuning. Seems to be efficient, but not measured yet. What's the difference between efficiency of this propeller and the other propellers? And it's not going into any kind of the flutter. I have not seen any red flags at all yet. But you feel that this is not the propeller made for speed or the high thrust. It's a propeller made for efficiency. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching, and until the next one. Bye bye.